be outside. Nah, it's the... Took my spot, but my second favorite spot. It's a little chilly, but it's not that bad. No. You got niggas stalking you. It's a different story. I gotta catch up on those episodes. I think his name, her name is, I said his, her name is Dr. Z. We got 15 minutes, so, you know, usually. I just go off the top of the head. That video was it was basically about the Asian American discrimination, which I condemn. I condemn, and I said it was wrong and everything else like that, but. To do the research, but then again, everybody just started popping out of nowhere. Like, they didn't want me to talk about it. You know, I'm American and China guy. Like CNN, I don't think it's, you know, I just gotta go to a, there's so many articles on it, but I just want to go to a source that people are familiar with. China says it has a zero tolerance policy for racism, but discrimination towards Africans goes back decades. Black version of the Chinese flag. Africans in China, but also by claims from Chinese state media that the allegations were groundless rumors. So the same thing that the Asian Americans are being attacked here for is what the Chinese were attacking the Africans in China for. And this article was written in May 5th, 2020. So that was just last year. So I can understand what the Asians is going here, but I didn't see the same support. It was more like Black Twitter. It wasn't like famous Chinese artists. last month, which was like a year ago, many Africans were forced. Many Africans were subject to forced coronavirus testing and arbitrary 14-day self-quarantine, regardless of their recent travel histories. Calls were left homeless after being evicted by landlords and rejected by hotels under the use of virus contamination measures. That's what I was talking about. The Africans, they were denied to go back into their apartment. They were evicted even after paying the rent and everything else because of the discrimination that they believe that Africans were the one who brought the virus over there, which is a lie. And it's funny how they quiet that shit down. That was just last year. And it's funny how it being picked up now while the Asian Americans are being attacked in America. You feel me? Which is also, it's kind of funny and it's ironic that they said the Asian and the Chinese discriminate against Africans in China. It's nothing new, it has been going back for decades. Well, that's the same thing the Asian Americans can also say in this country, that the discrimination among them has been going back for decades. But it's funny how that works, like, you feel me? They're both going through, it's amazing. China, whatever, the Global Times, a national controlled by the Chinese Communist Party, went one step further, publishing an article titled, "Who is behind the fake news of discrimination?" That is hilarious, but it's definitely not a fake news when you have Africans who are actually on the news telling, and you can see the video, it's definitely not discrimination. It's definitely not fake news. Saying no racism in China, and I believe the Chinese people are not racist, but I think it's just ironic. I mean, it do happen, man. CNN has pulled out an article. It's amazing what they pulled out, but this article was written by Gina Marsh, Jenny Martian, whatever. It was written on May 25th, 2020. That was last year, being 2021. It hasn't even been a year yet. And they have a lot. And they have a lot of evidence. They even go as far as, you know, talking about how many Africans are instead the most population of Africans in the same population in China, and how Africans did face some form of discrimination for dating Chinese girls. You know, students were basically the same thing African Americans went through when you try to date yourself a white girl. You thought you was gonna date yourself a white girl, nigga. There wasn't gonna be no consequences for that. Well, basically that's what goes on. When you have a group of people at a particular location, I seen this in New York too. When you have too many people of the same kind or the same race, they tend to be very protective about their surroundings. It seems like everybody else is like that except for black people across the world. It's amazing, yo. I just don't understand that shit. Bro, we need to get, should we be the way we are just to teach people that it's possible for you to be more inviting? Because it's amazing to me that people do treat people like that who come into their territory, who come into the sovereignty, right? Or the community. And I couldn't according to most, they're just protecting the community, right? But at the same time, we know these things go on. So we know for a fact that I've seen it and I felt it. So you niggas can't tell me shit about that kind of stuff. I know what it is already. How people just treat you. It's not because you're bringing any form of violence and you're not going to tell them. They just don't want you over there because you don't look like you. They don't want more people looking like you into that territory. That's all. It has nothing to do with violence, crime, or anything else like that. But when you go to Africa, if you go to home, if you go to any black community, Native Americans got to the Americans. We know these things already. We know when the Mayans came into Mexico. We know when, we don't even know about the Olmecs. We still don't know. We don't know about the Olmecs, but we know that the Olmecs was in were in South America before the Mayans and the Aztecs. You feel me? So we have a record of when most of these people came onto set and scene. You know, we know that, and we could trick you if you want to. We could track it back to where they originated from, but nobody can ever give us a record of when our birth came, like when did we come on the market. So we could be millions of years old. I say that to say this, man, that most of the Bible said there's nothing new under the sun. That's what the Bible said. Don't hate me for these words, man. The Bible said there's nothing new under the sun. We could have been here for millions of years. There's a reason why we are very humble in our approach, very meek. The only way you can see anything other than what I'm describing, if this, whether there is poverty or drugs involved. That's the only way you see a black man acting out in a way that he's not supposed to act out in. That's the only way. It has to be stress, poverty, some kind of drugs, guns, and everything else like that. But before that, Black people didn't act like that, you feel me? And that's just the truth. So we've been out here for millions of years. We've been. And we have to have been for how we act too mature genetic wise. Like we act too mature. Like we too welcoming, too inviting, too giving, too forgiving. You feel me? This speaks to a person's intelligence that has been here for so long that it's like we don't hold on to things like it's very new to us. You feel me? It's just that it's not that new to us. We be like, all right, cool. Like, you feel me? It's like we're very meek when it comes to a lot of things. Our intelligence, even when you hold it against us, we still tend to catch up in so many ways. You feel me? Just trying to make sense out of it, and it still comes back to the Wuhan thing and everything else like that. That of course we was being discriminated upon as Africans when we was in China because of the virus, and towards the end of the virus, African Americans who appear to be African Americans have happened to have been discriminated against. You feel me? That's not fair. But it's kind of funny how it's both. You just gotta pull the articles and just show it to them. It's just amazing. Both. It's crazy, but I just had to describe it the best way I can. It is what it is. I condemn both behaviors. You feel me? It's true. I just condemn both behaviors. It's unfortunate. It's unfortunate. Feel me? We can do better. Stand against violence on all fronts. You dig?